Esternal's little like restaurant filter.
So I'm here with Sarah and Michelle. Menu items at Prairie Noodle Shop, and we just tried the chicken wings, and now we're gonna try these little cute noodle cups. Do this one favor for me. Super summery and a little spicy, has like pickled veggies in it and a yuzu sweet soy vinaigrette. Apparently, I think it's their summer noodle salad. Now we're gonna try their miso soup. I hope she's waiting for me. It's not like your traditional miso soup, there's a little kick to it.
There's some kimchi in here. And it's got quite a kick. That's pretty good.
Like it doesn't hit you until like 10 seconds later.
In its totality, a pretty different experience. And we're keeping the cheese from the old soup. It'll be an add. I mean, if we ever took the smoked gouda away, it'd be pitchforks and torches out front. So it's our smallest selling soup. But it's also our soup that has the most vocal proponents. You know, so. But the finished product will have charred wilted greens, some of the bean sprouts, kimchi, tofu, and then a shot of that green sauce over the top. That was the way we were making it at Grant Mac, and we made it again, and I forgot all about the green herb puree on top. And Eric's saying, it's missing something. I said, yeah, I know. It's like, it's not quite there. And then today we remembered, and just as we were about to start service, I ran out and bought basil.
Next up, we're trying. It's banh mi. I think I'm saying that right. I'm not good.
That's good.
That's very good.
It's my favorite thing so far. It's like their version of a viet sub. It's really good.
Okay. It's cool because their meat is a little bit like barbecue. So it's really, really good. Really different.
It has like a barbecue pork flavor to it. And it's different. It's like Vietnamese subs with a twist of Chinese.
Yeah, that's a combination of something I've been wanting to do for a long time. I love Southern barbecue, and I grew up in an Asian restaurant. My dad's business partners were in South China, so they invariably ended up employing people from all over the place. I was like, okay, I got to eat stuff from all over. And then when I was 15, my cousin was going to med school in Dallas, so I got hooked on barbecue, and I always thought the two things would go together really well. Yeah, I just think it's like a natural combination. And if you take a look at like that southeastern corner of the United States, from the Florida Panhandle, like to Louisiana, and across into Texas, that's the largest concentration of Vietnamese boat people anywhere in the United States. So I feel like that fusion of food is happening there anyway.
So we have the ice cream for dessert. This is the mulled wine. This is the wild rose petal. and the French toast.
Just give me all of you in exchange for me.
Nothing in common, but so different. Yeah, we grew apart, so distant. Yeah.
The mulled wine. How did you guys like it?
That is such a strong wine flavor. Like, anybody who loves red wine would take this pizza.
I agree. It's really, really flavorful. And what's this?
This one is rose petal.
Oh, I like it. It's really floral and it's
flowery.
Really, like, light as well. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And of course, Michelle's eating all the French toast.
And it's so good. Like, it tastes like French toast bits in there.
It's really good. It's probably my favorite. Last but not least, we have the ice cream sandwiches.
Yeah, look how cute they are.
They're a chocolate cherry cola ice cream sandwich.